Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, guys.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I hope you guys are always healthy and stay safe at home, ya. Well, today we would like to present about cultures. Yeah, a few weeks ago we have discussed some of cultures. Yeah, in Turkey, of course, we choose Turkey as our country to be discussed. The first topic we have been discussed is about greeting custom. The second is verbal custom. And today we would like to discuss about voting custom in Turkey. Okay. Why do we have to talk about this? Yeah, because in addition to fulfilling ICC assignment, learning about foreign cultures is very important, especially for those who taking foreign language study program. Okay, now in the first slide, I would like to discuss about, the first is about traditional voting custom in Turkey. Traditional voting forms a part of Turkey's traditional culture. In the past, the Turks would wear their own clothing and make dyes from natural plant ingredients. So, in ancient times, the Turks made clothes by weaving, and the dyes used in the clothes they made from natural, from natural colors, and the materials is from plants. The clothes they made were their design is the clothes that describe their feeling, such as seen from the coloring clothes. If they use colors in their clothes, it shows that they are happy. And when they wear dark colors, it represents that they are sad or grieving. Yeah, all right. In the next. Okay, this is the two example of Turkey traditional clothing custom. There are yashmak and fez. All right. The first is yashmak, or it usually also called yashmak in Arabic. It is a long, narrow, fez print or veil traditionally worn in public by a Muslim woman, and the yashmak most frequently called a chadar or niqab. The costume of wearing the costume is centuries old, but it was slowly abandoned in the 20th century, except in the most traditional Islamic societies. And the second is fez made from fleece. Yeah, it is a felt hat dress in the shape of a short cylindrical peakless hat. It usually in the red color. Oh, it seems like kind of like peti. In our country, we call it peti, or in Japanese, we call it songko. Okay, the fez used to be common headwear in Mediterranean countries and originated from Morocco. It was popular accessory used by Ottoman elites and soldiers that became a symbol of common Ottoman identity in the 19th century. A fez also produced from broadcloth and the flat surface on top hat. The top hat had a hole through which 2 centimeters of broadcloth was placed, and a tassel was connected to the surface. Okay, the next slide will be discussed by Richa Luciana.
Okay, the next slide, we discussed about the traditional clothing custom. The third is Islak. Islak, a woman's attire, consists of the baggy trousers, so a t-shirt, I'm sorry, a shirt, so using the a face and a lot of jewelry, and the socks is tucked into the trousers. So the fourth is entari. Entari is a significant element of traditional culture which now is scarce. So it's important both for the cultural history of the Turks and in a wider context to establish history. And the characteristic of these garments, usually this cloth, can use for wedding, consists of more robes, may be worn. So it's made from a laying of green silk with coated metal thread. The silk was cut into the pieces required for the robe, and usually using a face and the slippers. So the next. Here we will discuss about the in Turkish clothing custom. Each region is different. There are the Asmaya, Amasya, sorry, Amasya in people who live in this region are very strict, broad-spirited, and independent, and their customs are made in the same spirit. Women's attire consists of a vestemal. It is a piece of line, usually stripped, wrapped around the waist, a shawl called kesan, which covers the head, torso, and face. Socks and shoes are slippers. In some parts of Black Sea region, women also use a blue aprons. In other female, custom consists of a dress made of black silk brocade and a bright orange waistcoat. If the men's attire consists of a baggy trousers or salwar, using a shirt, a jacket, so the headdress, socks, shoes, or boots. So the next is Aegean. Aegean is usually woman's attire consists of a long robe, baggy trousers, a short jacket, and apron. Several head scarves, sometimes with a face. So the woman's also by using the slippers and a lot of jewelry. Traditional fabrics are silk, velvet, and cotton. Every piece of clothing is embellished. And for men, attire consists of short baggy trousers, a jacket, a shirt, a white belt, a neckerchief, a headgear, socks, and slippers or boots. So the next. The next is the Erzurum, or the mountainous area in eastern Turkey. Men's attire consists of baggy trousers by using a shirt, so a jacket, a white belt, and a headgear. Socks and shoes are boots. Kurdish custom usually consists of a long robe, a shirt or undershirt, a white belt and a headscarf, socks and shoes. The men's modern custom often looks pretty European style. Only salwar trousers give some Turkish flavor to the garment. So the last is Şanlıurfa, or southern Turkey, near the borders with Syria. That usually the woman's attire consists of a long dress, by using a kaftan, a long robe, a belt, a headscarf, socks, and shoes. And then the folk there, dress of this region is rather laconic. It has only few layers. It looks very feminine and tender. So the pieces of attire are embellished with embroidery and jewelry. So, but moderately, not as richly as in some other regions. But for the men's, consists of baggy trousers, by using a shirt, a robe, a jacket, a white belt, or kerchief around the waist. And the clothing looks pretty simple. The outwear, usually by using the kaftan, jacket, vest, or robe, is usually embroidered. Okay, the next slide we will discuss with Amalia.
Okay, next slide is modern clothing customs. After the Ottoman period in 1923, Turkey has experienced changes in the term social life, including fashion mode. Along with times, the clothing culture adopted by Turkey is the same as the Western culture. Changes to women's clothing should cover their bodies with a black abaya or fez for a long time. However, with adoption of Western style, they were replaced by jackets and skirts. This style is called tessetur style. As we can see, this woman used a top that cover with a long cut, then use a veil, then she use a long pants, or they can also wear a legging. And how about the clothing for a Turkish man? Different with the old culture, a man in Turkey is really simple in modern clothing custom. They use a casual outfit for their daily activities. They prefer use long pants like jeans because this is the best choice to use. And even though the weather is hot, they always wear long pants with a jacket or a long coat, and probably use the glove if the weather is cold. Next. And in Turkey, also use clothing in the weather. Like in summer, they always wear cool cotton clothing because the weather is so hot, so they wear they use hats to protect their body. And then in spring and autumn, they wear a warm jacket or sweater and windbreaker. And the last is in winter. This is they need to use a clothing like warm woolen clothing. Like woolen clothing and rain gear. Next. So the conclusion for this country is, as we can see, clothing custom in Turkey has different characteristics, like in the traditional Turkey has Ottoman culture, that in the every regions in Turkey has different cloth and has different stuffs. It seems more complicated than in the modern times, but it seems unique. In modern Turkey, adapting these changes from Western culture, the clothing more simple and more comfortable for the woman and the man. So that's all from us. Sorry if there are many mistakes from us. So thank you very much. See you.